Here at Tormach, we want to help you get making chips as quickly as possible. So here's a video on how to install the power draw bar on your PCNC 440.
Please read the technical documentation that came with your product for all the warnings and cautions and any minor changes in future releases. When you receive your power draw bar kit, compare the contents to the item list in the included technical document. If any of these items are missing, please contact Tormach Customer Service via email, info@tormach.com. You will need several tools to complete the drawbar installation: a metric hex wrench set, a flathead screwdriver, a number 2 Phillips head screwdriver, 2 large adjustable wrenches, and thread seal tape. Since we will also be going over the installation of the filter regulator lubricator, you will need the following tools: 1 power screwdriver, 1 number 2 Phillips head screwdriver, a number 21 drill bit, a 10/32 tap, a tapping wrench, 2 push connect, and thread seal tape. To prevent the risk of an electrical shock, power to the mill must be removed before proceeding. Push in the red e-stop button, click exit on the PathPilot screen, click OK to power off. Turn the PathPilot controller power strip off, turn the main disconnect to off. To start the installation, several items will need to be disassembled from behind the spindle motor door. Use an adjustable wrench to loosen the factory installed drawbar. Support the TTS collet with one hand and continue to loosen the drawbar with the other. Set both aside. Use a 6mm hex wrench to remove the socket head cap screw securing the spindle lock. The spring can be moved to the side. Set the socket head cap screw aside. Use a 5mm hex wrench. Remove the bolt on the spindle lock block. Set the bolt, spindle lock, and washer aside. Using a 5mm hex wrench, remove the bolt on the spindle lock block. Set the bolt and spindle lock block aside. Using a clean cloth, wipe down the exposed surfaces inside the spindle motor cabinet. Remove the drawbar bushings and set aside. Take 2 cupped washers and align them so their indents are facing outwards. Slide this pairing onto the drawbar. Repeat this for the 3 other sets. Apply a bead of anti-seize to the uppermost edge of the drawbar post. Slide the first cupped washer into place. Then apply a bead of anti-seize to the outer lip of the first cupped washer. Align the first set of washers together. Apply a bead of anti-seize where the cupped washer meets the drawbar. Slide the third washer against the second. Okay. Repeat all these steps until all 8 cupped washers are lubricated with the anti-seize. Then apply the anti-seize to the bottom threads of the drawbar. Insert a TTS collet into the mill's spindle with one hand and thread in the drawbar with the other. Hand tighten the drawbar. Insert the empty TTS tool holder into the collet and tighten the collet into the drawbar using 2 adjustable wrenches. Place the power drawbar cylinder above the drawbar. Apply anti-seize to the threads and shoulder of the M10 by 16mm shoulder screw. Use a 5mm hex wrench to secure the mount plate to the unit with the shoulder screw. Using the pre-existing hole from the factory-installed spindle lock, push the quick-release pin into the power drawbar cylinder's mount plate. Using a 4mm hex wrench, remove the 2 M5 by 15mm socket head cap screws that secure the coolant hose bracket to the side of the mill head. Set all aside. Using 2 M5 by 6mm Phillips head machine screws, adjust the button box base until it is flush with the bottom of the spindle cabinet. Securely tighten with the provided machine screws. Using 2 M5 by 12mm socket head cap screws and 2 M5 nuts, mount the coolant hose bracket to the button box cover. Set the assembly aside. Unscrew the push button cap from the power drawbar button assembly and remove the first two O-rings, leaving the third in place. Insert the power drawbar button assembly through the hole on the button box base. Reinstall the two O-rings. Screw on the push button cap to secure the assembly within the button box. Attach some electrical tape to both ends of a 5/32 nylon airline. This will be used to identify the retract line. Connect this to the retract push connect elbow on the power drawbar button assembly, which is on the back and top of the assembly. Route the other end through the button box base and out the back of the enclosure. Connect the second 5/32 nylon airline to the advance line on the top front push to connect elbow. Route the other end through the button box base and out the back of the enclosure. Route the loose ends of the retract and advance airlines together up the machine's Z column. Connect the retract airline to the bottom push connect elbow on the power drawbar cylinder. Connect the advance airline to the top T connector on the power drawbar cylinder. Secure the retract and advance airlines together using 5 cable ties. Make sure the cable is unrestricted and away from any pinch points. Connect the quarter-inch air supply line to the air supply elbow on the power drawbar button assembly. Route the loose end out the back of the enclosure. This end goes to the air compressor. Connect the quarter-inch nylon line to the air compressor. Use a number 2 Phillips screwdriver to attach the button box assembly to the button box base with 4 M5 Phillips head screws. Temporarily remove the M6 by 12 mm socket head cap screws from the spindle motor cover. The bracket is installed in its place. The spindle head may have to be dropped in Z to allow the bracket to be secured. This will involve powering up the PCNC 440, lowering the spindle, then following the shutdown procedure described earlier. Secure the bracket to the button box cover with 1 M5 machine screw. If you're planning on using an FRL, this would be a good point to install one. Find a convenient location for the FRL, then mark the location of the screws using the mounting bracket. Drill the two holes using a number 21 drill bit, then tap the two holes using a 10/32 tap. Secure the bracket with the provided machine screws. Secure the cap into the back of the FRL using a hex wrench. Wind thread seal tape 2 times around the threads of the dial, and secure this to the front of the FRL with an open end wrench. Wind some thread seal tape 2 times around the fittings on the 2 NPT reducers. Secure them into the valve housings on either side of the FRL while taking care not to over tighten. Connect 2 push connect bushings to the 2 NPT reducers. Attach the FRL to the bracket with the top connection ring. Connect the nylon airline from the drawbar button assembly to the right push connect. Then attach the airline from the air compressor to the left push connect. Remove the cap of the FRL fill port with a hex key. Use a small funnel to fill the lubricator bowl with standard air tool oil. Only use oil that is specifically designed for air tools. Reinstall the fill port cap. Before using the FRL, the air must be purged from the system. Press the knob down to lock. Open the lubrication adjustment knob 1/2 turn toward the plus. Flush all air bubbles from the system. When the air bubbles no longer appear in the sight window and a droplet of lubricant forms on the bottom of the stem, close the adjustment knob 1/4 turn so that it is open approximately 1/4 turn from the completely closed position. After initial installation, the spring washer preload adjustment needs to be completed. Using 2 large adjustable wrenches, tighten the power drawbar to approximately the same torque used normally to tighten a manual drawbar system. With one hand supporting the tool holder, push the power drawbar button. If the tool holder releases, tighten the power drawbar in 1/4 turn increments. Push the power drawbar button after each increment until the tool holder does not release. At this point, loosen the power drawbar 1/4 turn. Push the drawbar button again, and the tool should release. The preload will need to be checked on a regular basis. If you notice a drop in performance, repeat the preload adjustment procedure. Failure to do so could result in tool holder pullout. If the gap between the hex head screw on the power drawbar cylinder rod and the top of the drawbar is between 1/16 of an inch and 1/8 of an inch, you've successfully installed your power drawbar on your PCNC 440. If the gap is under 1/16 of an inch, or there is no gap, then you need to make an adjustment. First, release the air pressure from the air compressor. Then pull out the quick release pin. Swing the power drawbar cylinder out. Remove the hex head screw on the power cylinder rod. Remove the M16 washer. Reinstall the hex head screw and tighten securely. Swing the cylinder back into place. And reinsert the quick release pin. Measure the gap to ensure it is between 1/16 of an inch and 1/8 of an inch. Press and hold the power drawbar button to release the tool holder in the spindle. Insert a new tool holder. The power drawbar automatically reverts to clamp mode when the button is released. The PCNC 440 power drawbar uses a manual push button with no means of locking the power drawbar in the unclamped position. Because of this, it is best to leave a tool holder clamped in the collet. This will prevent fatigue in the collet and extend the service life of the power drawbar.
Congratulations, you've now installed a power drawbar on your PCNC 440. You'll never know what you did without it. For all of our latest videos, click here, and for more metalworking tips, tricks, and stories, subscribe to our YouTube channel.